Welcome back to the GIS function of GIS Modeling 2. And in this lecture, GIS Modeling, GIS helps to discover many things and to create spatial models. And what I have discussed in the earlier discussion with respect to 2D, very simple model, of course, what the second part of the discussion covers with little bit more about the realistic models. And we have few illustrations. I'll show one by one. GIS modeling, this is the definition of GIS modeling, that it has got a number of discovering characteristics of the real earth system and to create spatial models. The illustration shows both spatial and process models. This is one such questions we usually ask with respect to reality. And there are two figures, two illustrations are represented. One is on the left hand side, one is on the right hand side. On the left hand side, you see that there are four mountains represented with the direction north, east, and the central part and the western part of it. And there is a dashed lines representing the red color is nothing but the river which carries water from the mountain when the rain comes. So this is the realistic situation of the earth surface feature. And that is a description here. River drains to shortest downhill path to the ocean and central mountain which controls, of course, this is the description. And if you see that this is the longest path of the river which carries water from the northern path and it takes the 100% diversion of the central mountain. So this central mountain is controlling the total movement of the water system, or the hydrologic characteristics of the area, the topographical features of the area, the vegetation pattern of the area, the agriculture practice of the area. So what I mean to say here, this is the realistic situation, but we could be able to model that how we can artificially change the direction of the river, and then how effectively the landscape could be effectively used. Where you need to have your modeling characteristics, and this is one such illustration representing and the simplification of the features. So all these features has not been directly digitized. Of course, they will be when the simple planner has started to draw a small diagram of the model of representing four mountains, and he is now simply thinking that he wanted to connect all the rivers. He wanted to have a shortest distance and he wanted to use the landscape very effectively. And he is connecting the river and which carries water, and then at one place and it joins a major river from these two mountains and then it reaches to the ocean. And this model is called a simplified model, and this model gives the reality in general, that's all. Nothing, no scientific input into it. So this is one such model. Initially people have started utilizing the logical characteristics of the landscape for hydrological studies. And the question always arises, if you prepare many models, what if is one such a process? What if happens, suppose if you change, or if you modify, or if you artificially change, or effectively think that how you are going to use the landscapes? Model A is a major stream takes long route around the mountain range, central mountain range. Other streams flow directly into the oceans, it is a very short distance it goes. So the last one which I have shown, simple model is one. This is model A, what if process. And what one can do, the other people have started thinking the modeling with respect to group B. New mountain position, if you just slightly, you cannot move the mountain, and then you think that you want to divert your water and to reduce the path direction, and then so that you will be able to get new mountain position. Major streams take short route to the ocean. So the total scenario of hydrology will change, but the question will come, is it possible for us to move the mountain? No, it is not possible. But a model, let's see, you can think of the finding shortest route. That is also the another capability of GIS, not to find out only the transportation route, but also the direction of, I mean, very shortest route of the river also can be able to predict. if you slightly look at the lower elevation or angle around the mountain, so that you will be getting enormous area for your landscape, for agriculture practice or vegetation, and total hydrological scenario also will change. So you don't need to waste water. And if you do only rerouting of the secondary streams, always it is better possible for us to think on the other side of it. So the model is one. Of course, there are three models which they have given. This is little back people have used, but now it is not like that. The technology has changed. And we have lot of data, like LIDAR data is with us. On the real-time 3D data, one can do with real-time 3D modeling, and we have a lot of tools like photogrammetry is there in image processing. Straight away one can do all 3D analysis, that how much of water will travel in the river, it is possible, and then those information can be taken into GIS for further modeling or further scientific analysis. Modeling, now accurate model has come, accurate 3D elevation model has come with lot of development in the data products. With higher spatial resolution, higher spectral resolution databases, now it is available for us to make more clarity of model preparation. The final part of the GIS function, or not final, in the present discussion, data output is one. And of course, this I have discussed while giving the introduction, that data output. Whatever the work you do is one, but how the deliverables are there, how it's going to attract and how it is going to be useful for the end user is the question of it. Normally, the technology has started of displaying the information. Even I had experience of taking all the information through camera and the monitor, taking simple photograph and representing in the thesis. That is simple way of representation, that is called display, simple display. But now technology is in our hand, that even very simple, I mean, very less cost will be able to take up to A3 size color printout. The map can be taken out at any scale, right from A4 to A3 and so on. Similarly, statistics is one. The data could be able to analyze with respect to the two different characteristics, or sometimes three different characteristics or multiple characteristics, to understand what is the total scenario of the work what you are doing, either with the satellite data in GIS or directly with the primary or secondary data in GIS. Yes, geostatistics in GIS is a major tool to represent your data output for scientific investigation and to draw attention to the end users how this data is going to be used. Tabular data, text data, we used to simply tell that the data should be taken into GIS, and then the data has to be delivered after analyzing it in the form of table, and text is the one sort of other mode. Preparing reports in the form of booklets. And then representation of digital products, right, from CD to pen drive and software, I mean small hard disk and so on, many things are available with a lot of space constraints. I mean a lot of space availability from 2 GB to 2 TB. You have many storage capacity devices like 2 TB hard disk and 1 TB hard disk, 100 TB, 250 TB, 36, 64 and so on. So this is how the data output is being taken and then delivered to the end users. Thank you for this present discussion. Thank you very much.